Greetings, minions, I am your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker, and I'm just here with some more Let's Play this here Total War Warhammer Empire playthrough on that there PC. And once again, as is always the case, I can't for the life of me remember what I was doing. Right, who am I at war with? Right. Sorry, just a minute here. My phone is being odd. Okay, there we go. Right, who are we at war with? We're at war with the vampire counts who are miles away. Those guys who are... Yep, miles away. The Crooked Moon who are right the fuck there. And Hawkland who are right the fuck there. Right. We're not at war with anyone in our immediate surroundings, though the Wood Elves hate us, they do. Granted, that's almost certainly because I just kind of, you know, marched in and decided that I was taking their land. But hey, what are you gonna do? They had land, I wanted their land. It's just how these things go. If you have land and I want it, well, I'm gonna have a problem. Okay. I also believe we were waiting for... Yep, we're waiting for that to build.
To war.
The Emperor's Eye continues to,
it is war.
Besiege that Crooked
Fight
Moon area.
Warrior.
The Archlector is still sitting there doing precisely dick. Emperor Karl Franz has taken the field, as has Boris Todbringer.
Indeed.
Let's put him there.
I command here.
And we could... Jesus, what the fuck was that? My voice just squeaked like it stood in a fucking vault. Right, let's actually recruit some more men.
As is my right by Sigmar's crown.
For Ald Franz. I'll tell you one thing, we're getting rid of you.
Ready.
Because quite frankly, I don't... Like, there is zero point... There's few times in this game where you look at a unit and realize there is literally zero fucking reason to use it. But that's one of the rare occasions. That when you realize there is absolutely no point in having...
Praise Sigma. As you say, sir.
Yeah, there is absolutely zero point in having the earlier form of unit. Like, at all.
I am France. They will obey.
Okay. Let's also get us that. Right. How are we looking over here, Balthy? How much do I need for the Imperial Pegasus? Level 21. God damn it, I want him to be level 21 so bad. It'll just be kind of great having him on a massive, thing, won't it? It will just be kind of great. Right, well, you know what? That's actually,
My will alone.
Let's not go harass Moussalon. You're fine. You're freaking out. Okay, why are you freaking out? Are you freaking out because we just lack... I think these guys are just freaking out because we lack... Yeah. Yeah, they're freaking out because I don't have any public order buildings in this province. That happens. Okay, I think Hawkland's just wiped himself out.
Your king sends brave men to approach me, this Hexenstag.
Hello. Really, Britannia? You want to end your non-aggression pact with me? It's probably not a good plan. I'm just saying. Probably not a good plan. Right. Let us upgrade one of these. Let us upgrade Aquitaine, or Aquitaine, or however that's pronounced. Yes, let us do that. Let us also look for people we can trade with.
Greetings, my countrymen.
Though I think we are... Okay, so we're importing those. I'm exporting 20% of those, 32% of those. Exporting iron. Exporting salt. There's got to be someone who likes me and is willing to trade. Somebody. Come on, Karaza Karak.
Greetings.
No.
What do you reckon?
You're not trading with anyone. The dwarven clans are built on trade. Don't you know that, you swine?
The empire is in your hands, not mine.
Ah, good. We can actually make peace with the dwarves. Okay, that's a positive. Sylvania. I doubt Sylvania will want peace.
Mortals.
Yeah. Thou. I suppose we could, once we've taken this place.
Into battle.
Yeah, there's no point in actually doing that battle. He doesn't have any spells, so we can't see him do anything cool. Loot and occupy.
Attack!
I suppose once we've dealt with the Crooked Moon. Yeah, once we've dealt with the Crooked Moon, then we could... Amber Spear. Then we could, go deal with the vampire count. And quite frankly, it looks like, Wizenland is going to deal with the Crooked Moon relatively soon. So, don't really think we need to worry about them. If anything, we'll probably just send him, give him orders to head over there and go fight, Skarsnik, problem fucking solved. Ah, one more turn. I almost want to genuinely dismiss, oh, I do not like the look of those vampire counts. But I almost want to dismiss Karl Franz and just give his army to Todbringer. Yeah, let's improve the omens, whatever.
True servant of Sigma.
Well, obviously we have to. We just have to. We can't afford him. It sucks. Okay. But.
Summon the Elector Counts! By the Comet!
Agree!
You know, if I just combine these armies.
Is it time?
And then get rid of. Legendary Lords may not be disbanded. Well, just keep him, like,
so,
hanging out somewhere. Like, maybe even keep him in the Brass Keep, just to keep orders. And that. Then, because then I have this army to play with up in the north. Plus, it means I get to play with Boris Todbringer, which is always a good get out.
It is time.
Which is always a good thing. And I can figure out the proper setup for his, army later on. Yeah, this seems like a plan. Go and deal with the vampire counts. So the vampire counts are kind of eating Stirland. And that's a bit of a fucking problem, given that we're trying to unite the Empire. Plus, we do have to deal with the vampire counts eventually. Do you know what I mean?
By the Comet!
They're not catching them, so... Yeah.
Pick up the pace.
Let's send our forces to go try and deal the vampire counts. Ah, I can't send him. Ooh, no, I can make... Yeah. Which one do I get, though? I'll get you.
Ready.
I have never had a witch hunter. Ever. Genuinely. Never had a witch hunter. Embed him with Balthazar. And let's change his name, actually. I'm just going to quickly double check what the name of the one from Vermintide is. Vermintide. I'm going to check on my phone. Witch Hunter. I think his name is Victor Saltspire, but I don't know how to actually how it spells his name. Okay, it spells it as I expected. Right, so. Okay, let's just rename him. Saltspire. Because, damn it, I like Victor Salt. Because, damn it, I like Victor Saltspire. He's not my main. He's not the character I play as most on Vermintide. Nope, that would be, the character I play as most would be the dwarf. But, he's a fun chap. He's old Vicky.
Alright.
Also, start sending Boris down. I mean, we can, so we might as well, you know what I mean? I mean, Boris isn't special, I just want to see him. Like, I just want to play knowing I'm playing as Boris Todbringer, because he looks cool. Do you know what I mean? Okay, I'm going to take that money, even though it's going to cause public order issues, because damn it, I need the cash.
What?
He got a new name, Theon the Ironclad Lord. Right, well, now I can replace you. Get out, make room for the Grand Theogonist. Oh, does he bring the Tattersalls with him in whatever army he has? Are the Tattersalls just a unique regiment of renown that belonged to him? Is that a thing? I don't know. Or did I put them in there anyway? I can't remember. I genuinely cannot for the life of me remember if he had... if that army already had the Tattersalls in it. I cannot remember. Clearly, because I'm thick as shit. Okay, let's.
Yes. By Sigma's right.
Okay, let's shift these over here. And that way we can bring both of these armies in an attempt to deal with the VCs. Ooh, we can get a thing that specifically increases public order of the entire province. Yes, please. I approve of that, if I may say so. I approve of that quite immensely. Oh, hi there. I don't know why the balance of power has come out like that, but sure. Right! Let's Todbringer this shit. Finally, I get to play as Boris Todbringer. And knowing my luck, Boris Todbringer is going to get eaten in this, because I've just looked at their army loadout. So they've got one unit of Grave Guard, Fantasy Skeletons, Crypt Ghoul, Skeleton, Zombie, Skeleton, Spearman. Big monster. They don't actually have all that much to be impressed with. No, they do not. They'd have two scary units, and those are the Blood Knights, who are going to be a massive pain in my ass, and the Vargulf. But if I recall correctly, the Vargulf is a bit shit. The Vargulf isn't shit. That's an unfair description. But the Vargulf's a bit squishy. It's a glass cannon. Like, it can do a fuck ton of damage, but if it, say, was to be hit by halberdiers, it would turn into cheese. Do you know what I mean? Like, it would just turn into fucking nice, squishy cream cheese. It would just fall apart. They'd just become this useless sack of shit. So, That's good. You know what I mean? That's a plus. Other than that, that's a fairly... It's a fairly shitty army, honestly. And granted, this is just going to make it easier, assuming that their other army doesn't immediately turn and go for Boris as well. This is going to make it a lot easier for, whatever the fuck his name is, the other guy. All Ironclad. The Emperor's Eye to, there we go. Sorry, I had bread at the back of my fucking mouth, though. Just before I recorded, I had a corned beef sandwich. Because, yeah, I'm the kind of weird motherfucker who has a corned beef sandwich. What? Fucking what? Come on! I'll fucking have you. No, I won't. I dislike conflict. Do you just like these quiet moments? Just these moments that we have to ourselves. While it's loading. I could edit them out, but I don't. You gotta wonder, why is it I don't edit them out? I'll tell you. Because I'm shit. It's because I'm shit. That's why I don't edit them out. Because I am shit. It's just how these things go. Right. Okay. So I was playing with a knife on my desk. Right. So... What do we actually have to work with? Now, this is actually going to be one of those rare occasions when I don't don't have to go chasing the enemy, so that's fun. Okay, so I've got a fuck ton of swordsmen, a couple of pistoliers, 3 crossbowmen, a handful of flagellants, and 2 halberdiers. That's 2 halberdiers. Desperately necessary. Oh my god, he's got a castle for a hat. That is amazing. He just kind of looks like a fancy Empire lord, General of the Empire. Which, you know, makes sense, because that's all Boris actually is. He's just a... He's not even a fancy one. He's just a General of the Empire with, a special model. Although apparently he's got a special sword that only belongs to an elect account. And he has 1 special ability that actually is unique to Boris Todbringer. When caught within the radius of Todbringer, those enemies whose morale is already weak must face further penalties to their melee abilities. Oh, so he scares people and makes enemies a bit shit by engaging them. Okay, that's quite cool. It's a good thing we've got him in the army. Right, so... Okay, so we'll have a front line made of flagellants, because we can essentially charge the flagellants into the enemy. And then we'll split up... How many do we have? We have a very awkward number, right. And then we can split these up into 2... blocks. Two blocks at the side, if only because then I could, when the flagellants engage, I can bring these guys forward and around.
What do you bid?
Have the crossbowmen here.
Swordsman!
That one unit of swordsmen protecting their back. Ah, and then also the halberdiers. So that way, they probably are a lot less likely to be attacked in the back. Because, oh, in the sides, because we've got blocks of swordsmen on the sides. Okay, so... Okay, so we'll just... Yeah, you'll just do one thing. Todbringer, I'm going to keep you... in the formation, just because you might be quite useful, and I want to hide. I want to, if I can.
Pistoliers!
hide the pistol is.
To battle at speed.
Okay, so then immediately spin round and rush into a slightly better position, because I didn't position you right. And frankly, because we've got piss all to do until the enemy actually gets here. Where are you, Todbringer? You know what, Todbringer? You're not a panicky. You're not a panicky sort. You will walk. Everyone else has to leg it. But you, Todbringer, will leisurely wander to your part, your area. Okay. So those hounds are going to be annoying. Those bats are going to be annoying, but they're not going to do much. The Vargulf is going to be an absolute prick. Manfred may be an issue. However, he is on foot, and I could send Todbringer after him after we're engaged. I don't like you. I really do not like your presence in this. And the devils of Schwarzhafen. Once we're engaged, I could send the pistoliers out to deal. I will send the pistoliers out to deal with the enemy once we're engaged. Okay. So what I want is as soon. Oh god, they've just charged. Okay.
Taking position for the Emperor. Quick march. Sigma calls. Get them.
Okay, this isn't going well. Right. Okay. You guys hit them. You hit them.
The Empire endures. Take it down.
Okay, those flagellants are eating shit. Right, I need the halberdiers to engage as quickly as possible. Swordsmen, engage. Okay, good. So now that's become a decisive loss. Send the... Try and get those guys. Right, okay, what's happening? Okay, they're falling apart. Right. You deal with that. You charge that. You guys go over there.
Ready for war! Charge!
Okay, I think the devils of Schwarzhafen are falling apart. Yeah, the devils of Schwarzhafen are collapsing.
Show us the foe! Halberdiers!
Good, the halberdiers have engaged the Vargulf. Weird that they're not just winning. Send you to engage. Fuck it, just send that entire block to go and engage where these flagellants are having trouble. Oh, sweet Jesus. Todbringer's dying. Oh god, why is he dying? Todbringer, you're supposed to be great. Just keep fighting, Manfred. Okay, that's where they went. Somehow the Vargulf is destroying. Okay, that's the one unit of flagellants is gone. Somehow the Vargulf is destroying the halberdiers, even though it's losing decisively. and should be crumbling by now. Okay, good, they're gone. Right. Halberdiers, I desperately need you to get over there and catch those Blood Knights. Okay, Swordsman, please go and fight them.
Turn around! Raise your weapons!
Okay, that's grim, the Halberdiers. Oh god, this isn't going well. What the hell are the Pistoliers doing? Over there. In fact, no, Pistoliers, shoot Manfred. Go shoot Manfred. A dead Manfred would be a dramatic advantage. Shoot him. Actually, no, shoot them. Just collapse, zombies, please. There are 9 of them left. This isn't going well. This might have been a terrible mistake. Shoot Manfred. Shoot him, shoot him, shoot him, shoot him, shoot him, shoot him, shoot him. Come on, shoot him. You can do it. I believe in you. Shoot him. Come on, if we can kill Manfred, this will be a lot easier. I don't care, I don't care. Ignore them, go round them, go round them. Shoot them.
Soldiers of the Empire!
Come on, let me get this. Come on.
We are ready. Yes, General. Withdraw.
Ready.
Away the wizard. Withdraw. I command here.
can't believe it. I think we're going to lose Todbringer. I genuinely think we're going to lose Todbringer the first time we use him. Okay, so Todbringer isn't dead, but he is wounded.
Withdraw!
Keep your heads down, men! They're casting spells!
Sigma Preservers! Sigma Preservers!
If they hadn't run, we genuinely could have done that, because they were heavy cavalry. They couldn't have kept up with the Pistoliers. God damn it. Okay, granted I came out the other side of that with a lot more men than they did, but sadly they did win. Hopefully Todbringer isn't lost forever. Manfred's been wounded. I don't know how much that's going to matter. Jesus, the Blood Knights. I should not have worried about that fucking Vargolf. The Blood Knights are what fucked me up. And the Blood Knights, I think, are the only things in that army that are still alive. Yeah, the only things that actually survived that fight were my Pistoliers and their Blood Knights. Only things. That's ridiculous. 12 men survived that fight as compared to the 163 odd that survived. Well, no, exactly 163 that survived mine. I almost wish it was my turn, because then I could just have my Pistoliers turn around and start having a go. You know what I mean? Send the Pistoliers alone against the Blood Knights. The fucking Pistoliers would win if they could hold the morale for 10 fucking seconds. You know what I mean? Because they could just keep running away and firing backwards. I remember there was, Just before this game came out, when all there was the Call of Warhammer mod for Total War Medieval 2, I remember me and my friend Beardy were playing that. He was playing as the Skaven, I was playing as the Kislevites, and I managed to win, despite the fact he wiped out almost my entire army, because he had two units of, I can't remember what the actual unit was called, but basically mounted riflemen, who would just run away firing at his forces, and that made me win. Because he just didn't have an answer to, he didn't have any range things. I'd managed to kill all of his range. So all he could do was try and, like, impotently chase, my mounted rifleman. Did get to a rather silly point, because if I recall correctly, they eventually ran out of ammunition, but the only things that were left was, I had two units of them, he had like four units of Skaven slaves, and I charged the Skaven slaves, at which point they all broke and ran, and I won. Cause that's just how shit Skaven slaves are. Know what I mean? I'm hoping Boris isn't dead, I'm hoping he's just defeated. Where the fuck did he get all those from? Well, obviously I lose now. But he lost all of these. I'll tell you one thing. I'm fucking chasing Manfred, I'll tell you that.
I will marshal the men. It is for the best. Worms!
Okay, yeah. Good. Boris Todbringer doesn't die. That's good. So that means I will get Boris back eventually. Sorry if you can hear my chair creaking. It's like a fucking Spanish war galleon, I know. I don't know why it creaks so much. It's dreadful. Oh, right. We're making all that money because I just lost an entire army. Yeah. Yeah. That's why we're making so much money. So when you lose an entire army, that's just kind of what happens. Right, well, I actually want to sit Volkmar in Altdorf. Though, no, actually, out of curiosity, before I end the video, I'm going to check to see if either Wizenland...
Approach us, friend, and make your offer.
Good. We have confederated once again. So now control Wizenland. Who don't appear to have an army of any description.
Nah. I am the Supreme Patriarch.
Right. Well, in that case, we need to get this guy the fuck out of here. Because we need to get Balthazar. To go deal with, because we need to get Balthazar to go deal with the Crooked Moon.
I am ready.
Grand. Right.
Oh, mighty lord. The fates have surely selected you for greatness. Thanks to my guidance, your tremendous power grows, as if driven by some divine power.
The instrument of Sigmar's will. Who calls?
Alright, so let's see what happens if we go and try and start a fight here. Pyrrhic victory. Don't care. They're dead.
To battle! Praise Sigma. No.
Right, well, I'm gonna have to call that a video, so that's gonna be all for me for now. Been able to something and as always keep coming carry on. Good day. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it. Well, I say that. I could have been having a terrible day when I made this video. You can't tell, and I certainly can't. Pre-recorded message and all that. All the same, if you're interested in seeing some live streaming stuff from me, if you look in the description, there'll be a link to my Twitch page, as well as a link to my Twitter in case you want to keep up with all the random gibberish I spew throughout the week. And if you're feeling particularly generous, you can always donate to my Patreon campaign, also linked in the description. Well, that's all from me. This video's over. Leave. Now. Now!
Do not seek the sideways thinker. Do not seek the pardoner.